Like, God, if you that one, if you did watch the SRV playthrough, you know, then you probably be like, why the fuck does Shane hate this one character so much? there's a lot. So Silky, this is the thing about the new mech right here. Silky can't pilot it. She's a co-pilot. I recommend putting Sho in it. In the Sabrine. Let me see. Where's the other... Oh, yeah. And then I'm gonna move Marvel there. And Todd's gonna stay in his unique mech. Ooh. Ooh, we have enough to do the magic customization. All round, just because everything on my team kind of uses different weapons. I want to actually see really quick how many aces I have. You're not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I only have 5 aces, okay. Let me see what I'm doing, what I have for attack points after this. Oh yeah, we declared war on the Keepers of Order, so that's a thing. Spiro has his own plans to kill. Okay, so first things first, let's see here. And deploy anyone in this one, because to be honest, everyone's pretty. Let's see here. There we go, Tetsu. So that puts us at 6 aces. Let's see here. Oh, okay, we're just doing this conversation now. As we saw how he fought Koji and V, yeah, no, he's not lying. Sell sniper kit. Let's see here. Let's see. Who did I have that was at 50? I put it. Okay, so I need one for Ange. Dio. Duo. That's it. Yeah, so skill program. So let's see here. Ange. I can only do it for one, so let's give it to Ange first, since she's going to be going through some actual combat. Like, she's actually going to be mandatory deployment. You're as vicious as ever. You could be. And just fucking great. Your customization. I will do the. Actually, you know what I'm going to do? Let's see here. I'm going to remove that from you, and I'm going to put that on Lancelot Frontier. So as you can see now, the G-Self now has three packs. The only one that does a full token change is perfect, though. And that just could sit and rot. Fuck that sheet. Let's reunite with the End Nautilus. Ah, these two have some history. Well, we know that, actually. Let's go to the catch-up session. So Tora is Dokda's son. They've all been upgraded. Gein is back, and now that he's combined with Mike Kaiser, they've combined to Great Mike Gein. Also, my gunner's here, meaning we've got the perfect mode. And now, since we have the entire Brave Express Corps, the joint Dragonfire attack is ready. Oh, yeah, and Captain Nemo's from this world. And And so is Gargoyle. I hope he gets Debrio because he's a piece of shit. Yeah, he's Lord Sala, Arsha, and Krista's side. And now they're trying to kill us. He gave Sala love, Arsha that he would build a future for the children, and he was a friend to Chris. Yeah. Also, Jill's here. Yeah, so she's at the point where, right before we destroyed the Misurugi Empire in V. But this time, Sumeragi's not here to slap some sense into her. Oh yeah, that's the thing that's happening too. It's Bidi Baba Dibu of the six tier boss. So she summoned Todd and Sho, but she doesn't remember doing it, because reincarnation. Okay. We got the Senko Bracer, which is another treasure of Mount Sakai. Todd will only join you if you have 5 points for, 5 Todd points, which are acquired throughout various objectives throughout the game. Yeah, now it's time to deal with Misurugi. As much as we would rather go and get the people that have been kidnapped, we don't really have much of a choice right now. In terms of tactics, going after Misurugi is much better, especially with the Keepers of Order siding with them now. Everyone in this group has some form of baggage. Hiryui's got a lot. Yeah, we don't have the Emirian army to distract Misurugi anymore. We gotta nail down that front. What mission is... Oh! Oh yeah, this is here! So because of where we are in the story, this mission, if you had a certain... If I believe you bought this game early, you got this mission way earlier. It's kind of like what happened with the Huckbin and the... Volt and Loli? I forget the other mech because I haven't used it as much. But yeah, this is Masaki! Which is from... He is the Lord of Elemental. But he's also an SR original. Yeah, I completely forgot this mission. He is here. Welcome, Sean. I legit forgot that this mission ends up here. I thought it was after Misurugi. It's not like Glaeus and it ain't the surface. He's got two cat familiars. The Elemental Lord of Wind. Also, because this is a special scenario, there is no, there is no difficulty. To be honest, this guy's better to get late. I'll be honest, just because his movesets, his spirit board sets so much better late game as opposed to early game. I guess I kind of like how this mech looks. And yes, the cats control mechs. Oh, funnels. So yeah, something's holding his mech back. Let's use focus right now. Oh yeah, by the way, it can transform. Really? And yeah, the only thing I do find kind of unfortunate with the Psybuster is he doesn't get co-pilots. Ah, shit. Yep. Oh yeah, no, this machine has auto repair, doesn't it? Or does it? No, it's because there's no other, thing on the board. No warship on the board gives me auto repair. It's a small HP regen, but it's something. Let's see. I'm mostly waiting for his SP to recharge. Psybuster isn't really good on its own. see. We already saw that. Let's see, can you use any? Yeah. Honestly, I don't know enough about this machine to tell you what the fuck is going on with it. Sidebuster isn't really one I'm the, because it's an SR original. Let's see, which one of you is the one that's damaged? You. Can you use intuition? Because Bullseye applies the map attacks, and they can't counter a map attack. Abuse some game rules. Let's see, can he not yet? This only gets one attack, but shit, that is some rage. Cosmo Nova. If you didn't have the early, if you had early access, I believe here's where you'd get Cosmo Nova. Kind of similar to how in SRV, if you didn't have early access, you'd be getting Black Hole Cannon for Huckabin at this point. Yeah, fucker just- I'm pretty sure that was just like an equivalent of a supernova. I'm not sure. There's our ships. Main thing is, it gives you some money and gives you some tack points. I mean, the X-Cross, let's see here, we've got Heroes from Another World, a couple war criminals, an evil emperor, Char Aznable, who is completely trustworthy. A couple pseudo-gods, I guess, at this point. Yeah, they're more of a peanut gallery. Yeah, well, we don't have a zombie on our team, so we're fine. If we had a zombie, we'd be having a different conversation. I like the cut of your jib. So he's got familiars with Kuro and Shiro. Nadia's all happy because she can understand the animals. What significance? And for that, we get the X-treasured sword and the X-treasured shield. So first things first, see Dio. Make him, give him proud ace. Now he's got a status. Let's see here. And I do like that. I do like the fact that of all the characters they chose for the returning in an old mech, they one brought the old pilot back, which I think they did with, because that's the thing, the Huckbin's kind of weird because there's been multiple Huckbins with multiple pilots. Sidebuster from Myers Gangs only had the one, so it's nice that they brought him back instead of making a new character. Let's see, Maito. Nioba. Also, by the way, Mike Gein's back. Here, skill program or duo. How much do I have? Oh, I'm still sure I need 200. Shit. Certain amount of confidence is necessary, but arrogance leads to death on the battlefield. You know what? That is actually very true. Doesn't even go to. Kind of appreciate the fact. Spiro doesn't even go to the pilot. He just goes to Kuro and Shiro. ...100 attack points, which means I can also get another ace pilot. Yeah. While they are familiars created literally from his subconscious, Spiro is just a magical creature. Spiro is not Aqua's familiar, per se, but it is... Spiro is a companion. He has the worst sense of direction. Okay, let's see. We're gonna get another ace pilot conversation because I can now make Duo Maxwell an ace. You know, that is the best description of Duo. He is, to his friends and companions, he's very chipper and nice, and very outgoing. Like, probably, next to Catra, one of the most outgoing of the wing pilots. But he's also very merciless in combat. I mean, he's literally running towards you with a goddamn scythe. Okay, I'm just going to double check really quick how many we get. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think I'm at 9. Yeah, I'm at 9 ace pilots. I create another save. Let us move on. Let us start the assault on the Mitsurugi Empire. And kill Embryo. Just don't just Amro by rank, please. Amro's been at this a lot longer. He is really good, and as much as Amro hates to admit it. Amro, you were the hero of the 1 year war. You're not. Yeah. Amro doesn't want to be a mobile suit pilot forever. Hell, he didn't even want to be a mobile suit pilot in the first place. As we saw in that one shot for G Generation, Amro just got into the Gundam. It was an emergency, it wasn't by choice. Yeah, the new Gundam is a rush job. Got rushed down the field to answer Neo Zeon activity at the time. Now, Amro has expressed interest in development. It's still a shame that the new Gundam just isn't going to keep up. So, okay. So here we've got Kaya, Yazan, Mask, Rock Pie, Rockin. God. So this is the defensive line to stop us from destroying, See, they do have a lot of people trying to stop us. Mask has it, it wants to destroy the G cell. See ya. Got a lot of people gunning to kill CERN members of the party. Yeah, that's what I mean by Rico and Gista getting, like, confusing as hell at the end. So much shit's going on at once. At least here, because you could read it and you could take your time a little bit, it's a little bit easier to understand. Yeah. A lot of shit about Char has survived. Makes sense, because, you know, leading Neo Zeon, Char was a very public figure. So it makes sense there's a lot of records about him. But the White Meteor doesn't have as much. Which, again, makes sense. Amuro was much more willing to take the back seat. He wanted to build mobile suits. Yeah, like I just said, Amuro. Some say Amuro was the better pilot. Well, looking at the track record of their fights, Char started better. Amuro developed faster. Ah, so they all went. So he's. He's literally setting them all up to kill Amuro Ray. What the fuck? I don't know, Spiro hasn't recognized any of you as ace pilots, so I don't think any of you count. To greater heights. Going to deploy a couple different mobile suits that different machines that we normally do, mostly so I can also, you know, basically feed some kills to certain machines. Here. One thing I will say, make sure, Char and Amuro get 5 kills and Char kills one of the ace pilot, one of the, named pilots on the board. Last time was a surprise attack. This time, it's cleanup. And this makes sense, like, tactically. I'll give them that. You'd set up a defensive line. We don't exactly have enough battleships for a breakthrough offensive like we did with the fact that we had Tessa literally in a submarine using cruise missiles. It's also we're a much smaller force compared to what we had in V. Let's put a pin in this. We got a couple. Oh my god. Oh my god. That is so many mobile suits. Well, if you need to feed kills for some ace pilots, now's a chance. Holy shit. The hunt is on for them. And yeah, everyone's got their sights set for Amuro. Start getting everyone moved forward. As per usual, I will keep these super robots on the front line. Basically, the way I run this mission is I kind of build a defensive line around Amuro and just have everyone else pick off units as they get closer. Like I said, the main thing, make sure Char and Amuro together get a total kill count of 5. And Char needs to defeat one of the ace pilots. I will say this is a good area for map attacks. I didn't deploy hero. Let's see here. Let's see how this. I will say I do like how this machine looks. It is a very interesting looking machine. It's important that Sho gets at least one kill here, just so I can get him to ace pilot status. There we go. Puts them at two. Oh, I have one kill. Yeah, that's Amro's first kill. Let's see here. I'm gonna let them come to me just so I can make sure the right units get the kills. It's all mostly just to feed kills to Amro and, Char. I did not mean to use that. Dytron's running out of energy, so I'm gonna have to pull him back. Ideally, you want to defeat Kia there with Char. Unicelized combat. Kills on Amro and Char. Three. Back. Let's see, what is Dytron's energy supply looking? That means as soon as this level's done, I put Proud Ace on Banjo, and we've got two more aces on the party. So let's see. Yeah, actually should put me at 10. Okay, fucking Seaboat, a little too strong. Yeah. They all are concerned with being considered the best pilots. Meanwhile, Amuro just doesn't give two shits. And now they're all just targeting him now. And yeah, the new Gundam is pretty much falling the fuck apart. What the fuck were you doing experimental work with? Hey, where is he going? You know what? I can respect that. Just because he rejected Char doesn't mean Amuro has the responsibility to decide the future. Fucking hell, we're doing this shit again. So let me talk about Gundam F91! We'll get back to that, don't worry. Nope. May I introduce, for the first time on this stream, the High New Gundam. This is the perfected new Gundam. You know what? What's a better way to show off a new mobile suit than with the fact that it has a map attack? I actually have this model. The only issue I have with this version of the High New Gundam for this game is the head's too big. Everything else is great though. But yeah, this is from the book Belarusha's Children. I don't really know enough about that book to tell you what the hell was going on in it that would lead to the development of this mobile suit. Thank you. But it's good. I won't deny that. I just don't know what the fuck it's about. Let's get Char in there for an all-range attack. It definitely won't be enough for a kill, but it should put him in near death. Let's see. I don't believe Simone has Mercy. Neither does Viral. Well, I'm actually better off pulling Gurren back to let him recover. Restore the action of Char. Another all range attack. Hey, no dog, no barking. I hear you growling over there. You just gotta let everyone know you're here. God, her energy is fucked. Let's see. Use Faith, just because I can't risk a battleship getting destroyed. There's no way Char's not going to get this kill. Now it's just cleanup. I believe I got everything I needed out with getting, you know, certain amount of kills, all that good stuff. She needs to retreat, let her energy recharge. Just bullseye and Valor. You're gone! Yeah, what's that mask guy got? So now that we've got access to it, let's see the new all-range attack on the High New Gundam. I will say, I like the wrist-mounted Vulcan. And yeah, from oddly enough, on this level, there is no point for fighting Mask with Bellary. It's, I think, the only time this happens. Or it's one of the few times it happens. Have Suzaku defend. I have a feeling they're targeting Lelouch, because if they get one hit on Lelouch, he's done. He's removed from the military framework, but instead of, like, seeing as a liberator, it's like, oh shit, I can go nuts and fight everyone! Okay, good. I was about to say, please don't let it be energy. Dietron. I should have used Valor. Probably could have gotten the kill if I used Valor. Yeah, like, I don't care. Why the fuck do they need to, like, actually declare war for the Reconquista? Like, they could just live on Earth. There's no reason for the war. At least that I'm aware of. I don't know if it's actually explained in the series, if there was a reason for the war. I just forget off the top of my head. Is this youth? Amuro is turning into an old man. Yep, the first line of defense is done. Oh no, Amuro was a pretty shit kid. When he was in the Gundam, he was pretty shit. That's why the bright slap happened. Hell, he nearly got them killed. Like, 3 times. Yeah, if it was given as an enemy, no harm in check. Make sure there's no explosives or shit packed in this thing. And some add-on parts for the double Zeta. We already know what parts those are. And yeah, it's probably assembled from the Rose of Hermes blueprints. If it's just built with the blueprints, it doesn't have... Because that's the thing. The new Gundam and pretty much every line Amuro pilots has a computer installed, a learning computer. So it uses all the real-time combat data of Amuro Ray to develop the suit. They bring it up in SR30 that if you just threw Amuro into a new model mobile suit, it wouldn't work as well because of the fact the Gundam is so tuned for Amuro. That if one thing's off with a new machine, it will completely throw him off, and that could lead to death. Ryoma goes to give him a little shit over, and he's like, ah, yes, this guy from Mr. My Getter is built for me. I think she kind of gets Amuro a little bit. And then there's this asshole. Oh, no, you're not him. Ah, yes, the urge to murder. rift between life and death, huh? I mean, that makes sense, as a couple of the pilots here are supposed to be dead. Looks at Lelouch. It had to be, of course, a world between life and... Oh! Oh, that's why she felt lighter. Fuck! Who knows the sensation transcending life and death? Mariana the Flash. In other words, you all are probably more familiar with her daughter and son. Nonnally V. Britannia and Lelouch V. Britannia. Yeah, this is Lelouch's mother. She has a Geass that lets her possess another person as long as her body is still alive. She possessed Anya for many, many years. But yeah, that's a thing. Makes sense that if we're in a world that transcends life and death, that she'd be here.